Well, it is a big weekend for local businesses. And some of the world's wealthiest people pour into Omaha.
It is the Berkshire Hathaway Shareholders Convention. KETV News Watch 7's Erin Natalicio is live from Epley Airfield with more. Good morning, Erin.
Good morning, Nicole. This morning, about three taxiing lanes at Epley Airfield are shut down to the public and reserved for TAC Air. It's a corporate airline that flies the world's biggest business people. And this weekend, a lot of them are flying right here to Omaha for the Berkshire Hathaway Shareholders Convention. It's a weekend of fun, food, and shopping. But most of all, and most importantly, it's all about getting down to business.
These are all steaks already ready to cut.
Steve Branicky of Garratt's Steakhouse shows us the hundreds, even thousands of pounds of steak he's got ready for this weekend.
Mr. Buffett's T-bone is a favorite steak, so we've been doing an awful lot of cutting of T-bones.
Garratt's is Warren Buffett's favorite steakhouse, and every year he brings his shareholders here.
It's fun. It's hectic. It's crazy. And, you know, we get a lot of people.
Branicky says he'll host nearly 2,000 people by Sunday night.
It's pretty large. I would say it's probably a month's worth of business in 4 days.
So that means big time preparations. Branicky doubles his staff, and he says they do triple the work.
Three meat cutters have been working 8 hours a day for the last week, so I think we're ready now. I think we're ready to go.
Branicky says he's ready to show off his restaurant and his city to the Oracle and the world. And other events this weekend include a cocktail party tonight and a shopping day at Borsheim's on Sunday. But most importantly is that convention on Saturday at the CenturyLink Center, where Warren Buffett will address his shareholders and talk about the current state of the Berkshire Hathaway A and B stocks. And no doubt the talk will also be about Warren Buffett's health and the future of Berkshire Hathaway after the release that he told us that he's been diagnosed with stage 1 prostate cancer. Nicole.
All right, Erin, thanks for that update.